Today, I'm going to show you how to make a C8 flashlight that will absolutely destroy any of the ones you can buy off a shelf. It's simple to do and budget friendly, so let's get started. The first thing we're going to need for this project is our host, and you can use about any of the C8 hosts that you find on the internet. Some of them are really super cheap, like this one that I got. If you saw my video, Internet Lumens versus Actual Lumens, I got this for about 10 bucks, and you can even get some cheaper than that. This one here is a Convoy host, which for a couple dollars more you can get, and it's considerably better quality, and I'll show you some of the reasons why in a little bit. The next thing that we'll need is the parts for our light engine. We'll need a Cree XPL High V3 emitter and a MOSFET driver. If you're using button top batteries, you can just put the driver in just like it is, but if you're using flat tops, you'll need to either put a spring or a copper button on the bottom. With that done, what we want to do now is we want to bypass this spring with a piece of wire. The first thing that we need to do for our mod is solder the wire leads on. For this particular light, I like to solder them onto the driver and then put it up through to the bottom because you can use shorter wires that way. If you need tips on soldering, if you're new to the hobby, I have a video right here on how to do that and also on how to reflow solder an LED to an MCPCB. Right now was also a good time to go ahead and tin the LED pads. It'll make connecting the wire leads to the MCPCB later a lot easier. Next, it's time to open up our host. This is one of the reasons I always recommend the Convoy host to people, is because you get this nice quality, clean shelf that's smooth and just ready to go. And also we get this. Right here in the bottom, you can see there's a ring screwed in. That'll hold our driver in place. Looking at some of these cheaper ones, right there at the bottom, you can see the driver just basically sits in there. There's nothing holding it in place except pressure. It's called a pressed fit, which is okay. Sometimes it can cause you to have a bad connection, or if you sand the edges of your driver too much, it can make the driver board fall out and it won't fit. In some of these, you'll get a 20 millimeter MCPCB slot, and in some a 16, and that doesn't really matter, but I mean, it kind of does if you want to order your parts ahead of time. Another thing that just blows me away on some of these cheaper ones is this. If you look at that, it's kind of hard to tell right here, but when I push on the back of this, that's not even an actual pill. It's just a pair of cheap aluminum MCPCBs stuck together, and the heat sink doesn't touch the LED or the MCPCB anywhere except around the very edges. Now, you will find in some of these that do have a solid pill, what'll happen is the emitter has been glued down to that pill. What you can do if you do end up with a pill like that is just get it hot with a torch. After a little bit, the epoxy will soften. You can just pop that right off of there. to clean this off, I always recommend using a piece of wood or something. Don't use something sharp like a screwdriver because you'll gouge the metal. Just kind of taking. You can clean it off like that. And then to get the residue off, what I usually use is some of this. That'll clean whatever's left on there. What you don't want to use is something like this. I've seen people do that, and this goes in a drill, and they spin that on there, and it just destroys that surface, and you don't get good transfer from the MCPCB to the pill anymore. It's like trying to carry water in a colander. The Convoy comes with this little set of screws, so rather than using two-part epoxy, we're going to use this thermal grease, Arctic Silver 5. Whenever you apply it, all you really need is just a little tiny bit. Spread it around real good. The thinner the layer, the better. You want to get enough to cover it good, but all you're trying to do is fill in air gaps there. You don't want a big thick blob. Thermal epoxy is not really a good conductor. It's just better than air. Stick it down in there. Just spin it around real good. You smear that all over. And then run your screws in. Just tighten them down just like you would like a car tire. Run them in gently and then go back and forth between the two of them and snug them down so that you get this to sit perfectly flat. Now that we have that done, just run the driver board up through the bottom and attach the wires. If you're really shooting for the moon on your mod, I like to put a little bit of contact enhancer, my deoxit gold, on the bottom of that driver at this point too. You can even get it down inside that switch if you just put some right around there like that and then run this up and down a bunch of times. While we're assembling, even though our Convoy host did come with a relatively nice lens, I'm going to go ahead and install a 42 millimeter AR coated lens. One final thing we're going to do before we put our light back together is on this switch. The weakest point in just about any of these mods, or at least the place where the highest resistance is in the spring. So we're going to do an electrical spring bypass by adding a piece of wire to the center of that spring. It doesn't look super nice, but it is going to give us a boost in current, and so we're going to go ahead and do that. You do need to be really careful when you do this, because if you get that plate too hot, it's gonna melt your switch and you've got junk. Just wanted to show you real quick the difference in the hot spots here. This is our factory XML hot spot. This is our XPL high hot spot. See how much more intense that is in the center? And it's not just the brightness either. This one is actually more like half the size what it looks like on the camera. It's just really, really tight compared to the original. I tested the output of our new super light and I got 1472 lumens at 30 seconds. And I also tested the range and I got 130,000 lux at 1 meter at 30 seconds. So I'm pretty happy with that. If you try this mod for yourself, let me know how it goes for you. If you want to see more how-to videos like this, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Good lux.